Today we're going to dive into a new update to Storyline 360 that allows you to define the actor and send over test accounts and with the actor as well, and a couple of those different options. So we'll explore that today. Welcome back. My name is Jeff Batts, and if you haven't checked out my website already, go ahead and check out learningdojo.ninja. Here you can check out all previous blog posts. I cover everything from Storyline to xAPI to Camtasia and everything. You can also download different templates and articulate Storyline 360, xAPI and video templates as well. And then I also have full courses, everything from A to Z, on Articulate Storyline 360, Adobe Captivate, xAPI Fundamentals, Articulate Rise, Custom Scorm, and HTML5 Video. A while back, Articulate released a huge feature to be able to trigger over xAPI statements at different points of the course. One thing that you needed to do in order to test that out is you actually needed, especially if it was going to an external learning record store, is you needed to create a query string, and that would capture the user and send over the statements. Without that, you wouldn't be able to send over or even test to make sure that everything is working. Now, query strings are still needed inside of Articulate Storyline 360 if this course is going to be outside of a learning management system or not supported with CMI5 or something like that. So keep that in mind. However, there is a new release. When you click on, if I'm in the home tab here and I click on publish, for example, I'm going to go down to not CMI5. We're actually going to report to an external learning record store, and then we're going to report and tracking, and then go into the learning record store right here. Now, this is the new option right here. Before, you could connect into your endpoint with your key and secret, which I'll do that real quick. I'm going to use cloud.scorm.com, which you can sign up for a free account. I use this for all of my testing. It's not the best looking LRS or LMS out there, but as far as compliancy and making sure that it is compliant across the board with SCORM and xAPI, it's probably one of the best ones to do that. All right, so I'm going to go into xAPI and LRS, and this is where I grab my endpoint. I'm going to grab the sandbox here, and I'm going to paste that there. And I need a key and a secret. So if I go into activity provider, and you can have different activity providers depending on where you want your data coming from. And I'm going to grab the key here, and I'm going to grab the secrets. Now, this is going to be different for your learning record store, so keep that in mind. If I click on test settings here, it lets me know that I've connected to that learning record store. This is how the course knows, because it's not going to be on a learning management system. This is how it knows where to send that information to. Now, the next thing is the actor. So the first thing is supplied via launcher URL, and that is the actual query string that I was talking about before. So if you know query strings, great. If you don't, typically anyone in your organization who handles the single sign-on or who handles like the Okta, which is a single sign-on, will be able to let you know how to add that query string. So as soon as you give somebody a URL, it's basically a query string, just to kind of break it down. Query string is, if I'm hosting this course somewhere on my website, the query string would be like, you know, a bunch of gibberish, if you're not knowing what it exactly is, but it's a bunch of gibberish that adds on to it that lets the course know who the actor and what their email is, their ID, who the actor is, basically. Now, if you don't know that and you want like a launch page to show, so right here, there is a Storyline xAPI actor capture, which will allow the user, when you first launch it, to enter in their name and email, and it creates the query string for you automatically. And so if you wanted to download that, there is also a video you can check out here that basically explains how to use that. So keep that in mind. But this is the new feature right here, where you can actually define just a sample user if you wanted to. And this basically is just, you can go in here and say, okay, I want to use the name, or sorry, the email of my own email, and I want to use my name. And so this would be basically, in this case, Jeff Batts. And there we go. What that does though, that's just for testing purposes, because before you had to go generate the URL and capture it and test it and stuff. And so this is just a way to do that statically. Now, if I come in here and click on static, there is also a random account as well. So if you're not worried about capturing who the person is and you just want data, If you choose random account, it's going to create a random account for you. But, I mean, I've seen people do that. And this is where I'm going to get on my soapbox a little bit. I've seen people do it, but that kind of defeats the whole purpose of xAPI, because that's more like, why not just use Google Analytics? Because Google Analytics keeps it anonymous, and you don't know who it is, and it just generates, you know, activity and stuff. But in this case, I mean, if you don't want to really know who the person is, great, and you just want to see how they're doing, great. But I don't know, there's really no difference there. xAPI is designed to be specific to the learner, especially if you're going to personalize content in the future. And so that's where I'm like, why do that? I'm like, why not just capture who the person is and do it there, so you can then personalize future content? I don't know. So it depends on your use case. I know that some people like to do that. So you could go ahead and choose random account. So you can also say static account, which this is a little bit different, because this is not capturing the actor. This is actually capturing a homepage and the name as well. But I'm going to go ahead and say static account. Now, I tried for about 6 hours and I could not actually get this. I was thinking, oh, maybe I can pull using JavaScript. Maybe I can pull an actor, or, you know, the name and the email from the course, and pull that there and use that as the actor. But Storyline basically locks that down. So I can't, even though this is calling a function called getActor, I can't update that later after the course is launched. And so try as I might, I could not figure that part out. So Storyline, if you're listening, or Articulate, if you're listening, please, please, please allow us to actually capture the name and the email inside of the course and be able to pull in the variable from here. The problem, though, because you could reference it here like a variable, the problem is this whole thing gets loaded before the course is actually loaded. And so I can't just use variables inside of the course at this point. So again, I tried for 6 hours, I could not figure it out, and I just kind of had to move on at that point. So that's a feature request that I wish Storyline would allow me in the future. But for now, that will at least give me, I'm going to go back to the, let's go back and update this. So I'm going to say jeffbat@gmail.com, and then I'm going to say Jeff Bat. So I'm going to go ahead and just say Jeff Bat here. I'm going to hit OK, and then hit OK here. And we're going to publish this out to my desktop. So I'm going to go ahead and hit desktop, hit select, and then publish. Now, keep in mind, I am not publishing this inside of a learning management system. If your learning management system allows for CMI5, you don't need to worry about any of that part. You can actually just track xAPI data right in your LMS. But this is if the content resides somewhere else outside of your learning record store or your learning management system. This is where you need to capture who the person is. All right, so that's done. So I'm going to go ahead and minimize that. And I'm going to open this up and I'm going to double click on story.html. Now, I am actually not triggering over a statement yet. And so I actually forgot to do that part. Let's go ahead and select this. Let's go to send statements. So when the user clicks, we're going to go ahead and send a statement, send xAPI statement. We're going to do experienced. We'll go ahead and just say custom text experienced page one. All right, I'm going to go ahead and do that. And when the user clicks on the button, let's hit save, and let's go ahead and publish this again. Let's just double check that, make sure the LRS connection is fine, and then our JavaScript is fine there. Okay, so I'm going to click OK, hit publish. Let's go ahead and close that out, minimize this, and double click on this again. Now I'm going to hit that. Nothing else really happened because I didn't trigger anything else besides the xAPI statement, so keep that in mind, but it is happening. So if I go ahead and close this, or go to my SCORM Cloud account through this LRS viewer, we're going to go to the sandbox here, and you can see right there, Jeff Bat completed untitled slide. Why is it saying untitled slide? It's because these are completed and attempted and experienced. Maybe I didn't change that from untitled there, but let me go back into here. No, that's what actually happens automatically. So it did not trigger my latest one though, so I'll have to take a look at that. But you can see my first one, I might have to relaunch it here. Let me try this one more time. Oh, I was actually launching the wrong one, so I need to go into sample. There we go. Now I'm going to click on that. So I published out because I named it after I published. So that's why I was doing it in a different one here. So you can see that now I should get that data in there. So yep, Jeff Bat experience page one. With Storyline, it does send over some automatic statements. And so it did send over those as well, but I do have that custom one and I clicked it twice, but I do have that custom one here. So it is working. It is gonna say Jeff Bat every single time, but I at least know that it's working. And so that's where you'd then have to come in. If I hit publish, I would then have to come in and switch this over once I know everything is working. Supplied via launch URL, and that's where I pass it in as the query string. So Articulate even says to work with your IT department on this, or if you want to download that template like I was talking about before, this at least allows you to have a first page where they enter in their name and their email, and it will create that query string for you so you don't have to figure all that out yourself. Hopefully that helps, but that is a new update inside of Articulate Storyline that I at least wanted to cover. If you have any questions, feel free to type them in or go to my YouTube channel and like and subscribe to this video and make a comment down below. If you want to see Articulate allow you to capture the person from the variables, I mean, let them know down below as well. But if you have any other suggestions as far as what you want to learn with xAPI and Storyline, feel free to comment down below as well. But that's it for today, and I'll see you in the next one. Thanks, everyone.